Hi, my name is Evan Lowe at Mechanical Simulation, and in this video, I'll be reviewing the new Euro NCAP AEB VRU simulation examples that are included in CarSim 2020.1, and they can be found in the collision detection category. As a brief background, Euro NCAP stands for European New Car Assessment Program, which is a commonly used vehicle safety rating program that includes a battery of tests and has been in existence since 1996. The specific examples that we have in CarSim 2020.1 are from the Euro NCAP AEB VRU test suite. AEB stands for Autonomous or Automatic Emergency Braking, which is an advanced driver assistance system commonly found in vehicles of today. VRU stands for Vulnerable Road User, which can be considered to be a pedestrian, bicyclist, or even a motorcyclist in some definitions. An initial test conducted during the setup of an AEB VRU test is the collision detection check. This assures that when AEB is not active, the vehicle will strike the pedestrian target at a desired percentage of the vehicle's width. We have a designated example for this, which shows you the precise moment when the vehicle strikes the pedestrian and shows you the percentage of the vehicle's width at which it strikes. For this particular example, the strike percentage of the pedestrian to the vehicle is set to 25% from the vehicle's near side. With each AEB VRU example in CarSim, this collision check is performed first before conducting the rest of the test. If the collision check fails, the run will terminate and a message in the log file will explain that the test failed because the ego vehicle did not align with the pedestrian target at the correct strike percentage. For the CPNA 25 or car to pedestrian near side adult 25% example, after the initial collision check, the CarSim browser events will reset the vehicle to the first test run with AEB activated. With proper tuning, the ego vehicle will complete each test run at speeds from 10 to 60 km per hour in 5 km per hour speed increments. Official scoring will be automatically tabulated based on a scoring table entered via a VS generic table screen. A live plot can be seen on the right, where the cumulative score is shown with the gray color and rectangular marker. This 2D scoring table seen here is linked through the procedure and contains points profiles for each AEB VRU test as specified in the Euro NCAP AEB VRU assessment protocol. Another AEB VRU example included in CarSim 2020.1 called CPNC 50 or Car to Pedestrian Near Side Child 50% utilizes a child pedestrian target and adds occlusion vehicles. These two standard size vehicles occlude the vision of the CarSim camera sensor, and the AEB controller logic does not begin to function until full view of the child VRU is perceived by the camera sensor. After this detection and perception occurs, the rest of the AEB logic performs the same as that in the CPNA 25 example shown earlier. We also included a version of the CPNA 25 example that instead of having AEB logic in VS commands, the AEB logic is implemented in several blocks of a Simulink model. This Simulink representation of the AEB logic was created so the user can swap their own AEB logic for logic we provided in the Simulink AEB example. This way, the user can get the same functionality out of the AEB test setup, including the events that automate the whole test process, while using their own logic and tuning parameters. Additionally, there is an example which demonstrates that when the AEB logic includes poor tuning values, the resulting ego vehicle system performance is poor. And the Euro NCAP AEB VRU test score reflects this poor performance. It should be noted that a perfect score for this particular test is 20. It should also be noted that for each CarSim AEB VRU example, if the vehicle strikes the pedestrian during the part of the test when AEB is active, the vehicle will reset to the next test speed and associated starting position based on CarSim VS events. Finally, we have an example that includes only one run in which the user can adjust the vehicle start speed, AEB logic, and AEB tuning parameters to tune the overall AEB system. This can be done for all of the speeds associated with a given test to achieve optimal results in the full test examples. This concludes the introduction to using CarSim to simulate Euro NCAP AEB VRU tests featured in CarSim 2020.1. Thank you for watching, and please like this video if you enjoyed the content and subscribe to our channel for even more CarSim, TruckSim, and BikeSim content just like this. And don't forget to check out our mechanical simulation website at carsim.com.